Develop your research question and actually find stuff. Picking a research topic for an assignment can be overwhelming. Here are some ways you can work with a topic to develop a research question and get started. Whether the topic is assigned or you've picked your own, you're likely starting with a broad topic. Censorship is an example of a very broad topic. Consider what you'd like to learn about the topic and try phrasing the topic as a question to make it more manageable. Try narrowing your search by looking at one aspect of the topic. For example, you could look at a specific industry using the question, "How does censorship affect Canadian libraries?" Another way to narrow your topic is by looking at it in relation to social, political, or economic issues. You might ask, "What laws protect citizens from censorship?" You could also narrow your topic by considering a specific population group, such as students, Indigenous people, children, or people working in a profession. For example, how does censorship affect children's literacy? Consider examining the topic in relation to a specific location, such as Canada, or in relationship to another topic. For example, how does censorship affect freedom of speech on the internet? Once you have restated your broad topic as a more manageable research question, identify the main concepts in your research question as your keywords. Keywords can be single words or phrases. Consider the question, how does censorship affect Canadian libraries? What are the main concepts? Let's try censorship, libraries in Canada. Ready to try your keywords? The next step is to connect them together to find the most relevant results for your project. Start your search using Page 1 Plus, located on the homepage of the library website at library.georgiancollege.ca. Enter the keyword censorship in the search box, then click search. While we're specifically looking at the library's resources right now, you'll get better results from Google too if you start with your keywords. Notice how many results Page 1 Plus has found for your keyword censorship. There are too many to review. Instead, build a better search by adding your other keywords to the search box. Click on the advanced search link to continue. Each concept from your research question should be placed in its own line. Try the search using censorship on line 1, libraries on line 2, and then use the plus icon to add a new line with the keyword Canada. Page 1 Plus automatically applies the connector and to combine your keywords into one search. This will narrow your search to a more manageable and relevant set of results. Now you're seeing results in Page 1 Plus that contain the keywords censorship and libraries and Canada. It retrieved only the sources that matched all keywords. How did your search work out? If you didn't find what you wanted, you might need to use alternate keywords, different words or phrases that have the same meaning as your main keywords. When we searched censorship and libraries and Canada, we got results that were more focused on our research question. Not sure what keywords or alternate keywords to use? Search a thesaurus, skim the table of contents in a book or textbook, read the subjects and keywords in a relevant article. Google or Wikipedia, and even a generative AI tool can be helpful to generate ideas and keywords. Just check with your professor to make sure it's okay. Let's try a search with some alternate keywords. Use the connector OR to include alternate keywords in your search. Place them in the same search box as the corresponding main keyword. Type the connector OR between the keywords. Page 1 Plus doesn't do this part for you. For our search on censorship, let's try adding in freedom of speech as an alternate keyword. Notice that including the alternate keyword increased our results. Alternate keywords can be very helpful in finding additional sources on your topic. For example, if you're searching the keywords Indigenous peoples, you may want to consider broadening your search by adding terms such as First Nations or Aboriginal to address terminology changes. Now that you've learned about keywords and alternate keywords, try some searches on your own. If you need help, check with the Library and Learning Services team.